One of the effects of climate change can be the rapid and unpredictable spread of non-native or invasive species. In new environments, invasives may have no known predators, so they can spread unchecked and cause significant ecological and economic impacts. Not all invasive species cause environmental problems. Thus, research is needed to prioritize which species need to be managed. Shellfish wardens on Martha's Vineyard became aware of invasive tunicates, or sea squirts, overrunning commercial shellfish and eelgrass in some coastal ponds in the mid-2000s. Eelgrass is a critical nursery habitat for many species of fish and shellfish, so EPA partnered with the Woods Hole Oceanographic Institution to study the impact to the ecosystem.
We found that tunicates blocked up to 75% of light reaching the eelgrass plants. This negatively impacted the growth rate. The more tunicate coverage there was on the eelgrass plants, the greater reduction there was in the growth of the individual eelgrass plants.
The second way that tunicates have an impact on these ecosystems is they are incredible filter feeders. And so they sit and pump water through and feed on phytoplankton in the water column that normally would be going to other species. So they're altering the normal food web of these systems.
Allowing for factors like tide, tunicate population, and the range of filtration rates, scientists estimated the tunicates in Stonewall Pond could filter feed the entire volume of the pond in 1 to 17 hours. To test how tunicate filter feeding affects the ecosystem, scientists conducted a stable isotope analysis to determine what the invasive tunicates are feeding on.
We collect the samples in the field. They're placed into plastic bags with a label. From there, they're placed on ice and frozen until we're ready for the analysis. And when we are ready for the analysis, the samples come out of the freezer, will be placed in a drying oven. It'll be placed there for probably 48 to 72 hours until the sample is dry. And at that point, we grind it up using a mortar and pestle, a lot like you would in the kitchen to grind up spices.
Scientists use an isotope ratio mass spectrometer to analyze the chemical makeup of each sample. This helps them determine each organism's diet and what their diets have in common. The results of this analysis indicate the invasive tunicates are feeding on the same things as commercial shellfish. The research shows invasive tunicates are impacting important native species in two ways. First, due to their rapid growth and reproduction, tunicates can smother eelgrass, reducing its growth and potentially killing all the eelgrass in an ecosystem. Second, tunicates feed on the same food resources as commercial shellfish. Tunicates will colonize boat hulls, buoy lines, lobster traps, crab pots, and any other items that have long residence times in the water. To help minimize the spread of these organisms, gear covered with tunicates should be scraped clean prior to being moved to new water bodies. Scientific studies like these help us manage our natural resources and aid EPA in meeting its Clean Water Act mandate of maintaining fishable and swimmable waters in the United States.